It is Footy Talks for this Friday lunchtime, presented as always by Benjamin Moore. It is Tony Kapka, the TFC defender, Toronto FC's newest addition, of course. And we now have in the same place at the same time online, Toronto FC's only two ever Scottish players, both defenders, Stevie and Tony Gallagher. Thanks for joining us, Tony.
Pleasure to be here. Thanks for having me, guys.
We'll just let you two talk together for a little bit about the penalty shootout and what happened yesterday, because it was a very stressful afternoon for Stevie, but ultimately he left the studio smiling when we'd done that Scotland game, didn't
he? Yeah, he was a relieved man.
I did. Did you get to watch it, mate?
I managed to get a stream only the last 20 minutes or so, though, but... Right.
That's fine. The rest of it was
back. Yeah, that's what they were saying. I was leaving back home. There wasn't much to see anyway, so I probably tuned in at the right time.
How have you settled in with life in Toronto and what must have been a really difficult circumstance coming over the quarantine? I heard you say you'd never been to Canada, North America before, and then the move en masse with everybody to Hartford. What's it been like for you, Tony?
Yeah, it's not been at all what I expected. But obviously, that's the way it is just now. So coming over wasn't a problem, not at all for myself. I'm willing to do the travel and stuff, as I've proven. And settling in-wise, it's been made easy for me. I came in and then getting to go away with the boys, it's almost like a pre-season, getting to be with them in the hotel, spending like breakfast, lunch, dinner, training. You're always with them. So in that sense, it was good to get to know as many of them as quickly as possible. So obviously I know it's not been normal circumstances for any of us. So as a team, we're coping with it. And myself, I'm finding it quite easy, to be honest, like with the boys and the manager, the coach and staff. It's been good for myself, yeah.
Tony, how long did it take you to realise when you stepped into the environment that it's an environment that requires winning right away? Because I think there's been a common thread over the last few years with TFC acquisitions that they get going pretty fast, and those that don't leave pretty quickly as well, because that winning mentality is ingrained in you pretty quickly, I would imagine.
Yeah, of course. Obviously, coming from like an academy team based... Sometimes they focus more on development rather than that winning mentality. So I knew at this point in my career, like, I needed to get most of that in back into me, because I came from Scotland, from first team football, where a win's everything. It doesn't matter how you do it. If you need to grind out wins, if you need to... There's just different ways to do it. So coming over, I didn't know too much, I'll be honest. I didn't know too much about the league, about the team. But I made sure to do my research. I had plenty of time in my quarantine to do that. So I was well educated on that. But for me, it's ideal. At the stage of my career right now, just turning 21, coming into a team that wants to win trophies and go for the wins and everything, it's like the perfect situation, definitely.
Who's taking you under the wing, Tony? Who's sort of made you feel most welcome, and who are you kind of kicking about with in Hartford?
Well, at first, there was that connection with Christian Wenger, obviously, with the Liverpool connections he's had. So I came in and he was talking to me, talking about stuff when he played, who the manager was and stuff. But ever since I've been here, going for coffees and stuff with Griffin, Jacob and Kev, the goalkeeper, just all the 99s. And so I've managed to sneak my way in, make a four of that three there. So... But to be fair, you can sit down and talk to any of the boys. They're all easy going. I'm sure you all know that yourselves. So there's a lot to talk about. There's connections with some that have maybe played over in England ourselves, asking how I'm getting on, what Liverpool's like, the club, what they've done in the last few years. So there's been plenty to talk about and plenty of players that have welcomed me in with open arms, definitely.
We talked to Alejandro Pozuelo last week. He said there's quite a rivalry going on the table tennis table, ping pong. Is that are you involved in that? Or
I tried to get in, but it's been a few years, so I'll just leave it at that. It's been a few years, so. But not to be fair, I wasn't expecting. There's a few Lolo. He's quality. Griff as well, and yeah, Poz. I've seen them. I've seen a good few. I'm not at that standard. I'm not going to lie. Yeah, I'm not there. I'll just sit and watch and. Yeah, I'll just stay there. That's fine.
When we spoke to Chris Mavinga a few weeks ago on this show, back June, July time, he was talking in glowing terms about what it was like for him and his development being in that situation at Liverpool. Just that club environment of such a storied club with a a past of developing players and winning things. And I just want to get your thoughts on what it's been like there for you being in and around that environment over the past couple of years when this is a team that has achieved so much and just what it's like to be involved in that Liverpool environment.
Yeah, as you said, especially the time that I've came in has been the time where they've rocketed, they've won everything you can really imagine, like you'd want to win as a player. So the 2.5 years I've been in, the spirits have definitely been up there, as you can imagine. The under-23s, we follow the first team schedule. The training's based, it's very similar. So anytime I've been asked to go up, the training's been, I've been used to what the manager puts out. The standards that you train to are always like kept high throughout the academy to the first team, of course. So being part of that has been a great experience for me myself. I never would have thought anything of that. Like growing up, you just dream of that stuff, like being part of and being involved in something like that. So, but ever since I've been in, it's been good. I've had a few chances to train, and obviously that big game against Aston Villa that probably might not happen again in football, but I was lucky to get the chance to go in there. But yes, the experience is great. Being part of the coaching staff there, they know obviously what to do with developing players, as you said. So the 2 years I've been in, there's been a lot of highs, definitely.
KJ is a Villa fan, by the way, so there might be
a game, bring that up,
game more recently that he watched.
No, I'm not going to bring that up. It's fine. A lifetime of getting tormented by Liverpool. It's gone our way the last two times. I understand it won't happen then again, so I'll enjoy it. But Tony, you've got your chance right away when you've come over. I think that's certainly helped your development as well, and you're not just become like a fringe player who's looking to get in. I want to ask you about that ball that you played into the box for Ayo Akinola, because I suggested to Greg Vanney in a press conference recently that before you were signed, he was often trying to play Richie Larea there or Auro when Justin wasn't available, and you brought great balance because you can open your body up a little bit and you can swing in that ball on that left foot. Maybe you can just talk to our viewers a little bit about what that was like to get down that width, look up and play a ball in like that leads to such a massive goal. What was the feeling like inside when that went in?
Yeah, and it was one of those ones, as soon as it comes off your foot, I knew I got a good connection on it. I knew I always going to the back post as well, so he managed to, well, he says to me, I made it easy for him, which is a good compliment. So, but at that moment, even when I first came on, my first few touches, I knew there was space with the way Philadelphia were playing. They were playing a narrow diamond. So that suited me. That's my game. I like to bomb forward, use the space in front of me and put those crosses in. And when the ball from Markey as well, that just set it up. Like just ran onto it. One, two touches, and then I was where I wanted to be. So it was just all about concentrating on that connection. Make sure I was just ultimately in that position. You just make sure you're beating the first man. And I knew as soon as it came off my foot that I'd done that. And all I needed was Ayo to do the finishing touches, and he did that. So the feeling was unbelievable, definitely.
Tony, he's been here 3 weeks, Stevie, and I think we've already given him the award as the best assist in a Toronto FC jersey from any Scottish player.
The only assist from any Scottish player in
the world. You must have got a flick on at the front post, no?
No.
Nothing. No?
That was a ball that I'm incapable of doing as well, guys. For me and my Toronto FC. I don't think so anyway.
The handout assist easy in MLS, and Stevie still weren't able to get one.
I kind of want to ask you, Tony, your hopes and aspirations in your career. You know what? You're now playing first-team football. You know, where are you in your mindset? Maybe you don't want to think too far ahead, but I know what it's like, you know, going out on loan, being at a bigger club, and then when you go back and you maybe step back into that reserve environment, you're like, really? You know, you don't get the same spark from playing. So have you thought that far ahead, or what you're thinking for the next steps of your career?
Yeah, of course. You're always, as you understand, you're always thinking about the future. It's like it's always in the back of your head. Like one day you'll be just chilling, thinking about what it'll be like. Because obviously this is my first loan, and I don't think many players get loans like this, where teams are going for so many trophies and try to win as much as they can with that winning mentality we spoke about. So going back will be whenever I go back. Like, that's another thing in the future. Like, no one can plan for that, whether what's going to happen next year. That's a question that can't be answered at this time. But as you said, going back will be different, definitely. Obviously, I'm not getting the fans, that type of thing from the stadium, a home game, which all the boys tell me is so good, which is sometimes I just think about being unlucky at this time. So definitely going back is something to think about. Of course, first team football is ideal right now. I'm loving every second of it. So I can imagine whatever time I go back, I'll just want more of it. I just want to get straight back out and get going again, because this is, I've turned 21 now, as I said, so this is ideally where I want to be from now, and then the next couple of years just kicking on, trying to get as much experience and minutes under my belt. So I'm definitely thinking about going back, but at the same time, I just want to keep playing first team football, and at here, Toronto, that's where I'm at, yeah.
And lots more games, lots of big games to come in the next few weeks for TFC, absolutely. Congratulations on what you've achieved so far with the club, hitting the ground running, Tony. And thanks so much for your time today. We'll let you get back to the ping pong tournament.
Tony
Gallagher of TFC, live from Hartford with us on Footy Talks. That just about wraps up this week's show. We'll be on the air on Sunday this week, isn't it? All the days just blend into one at this point, I think. But Sunday night, Nippert Stadium, it will be TFC's final visit there, because Cincinnati are moving to a new stadium, hopefully next season. So it'll be on the turf at Nippert Stadium. They had a big win. Was it last year, the 5 goals that they scored, or was it the year before?
Last year.
It must have been last year.
Yeah, and I did the game, Luke, actually. Stevie was...
Yeah, I was away with Canada.
Canada, so yeah, 5-1.
Well, I remember it. It was memorable, yeah. So yeah, we'll be there for that. And obviously, we talk about what Greg Vanney might do with his lineup, but for TFC... We've seen them get through these difficult games against difficult opposition, Columbus and Philadelphia, New York City FC. Sometimes they are able to raise their game, aren't they, in those big games, KJ? And
yeah.
As a player, Stevie, you would know, sometimes when you go into those games and Cincinnati scored 8 goals all season, that's when it's maybe a little bit more difficult to reach those levels that you have when you're playing a Columbus or a Philly.
Yeah, that's the team talk, isn't it? Don't take this lightly. Just... you know, focus on ourselves. It's much what we talked about with John. It's modern day coaching. I think modern day management is, you know, let's do what we're good at and let's stick to our game plan. And whoever's wearing that shirt, whoever's lucky enough to play certain positions, go and do the job and just treat every game like it's your last. It's such a cliche statement, KJ, but I love saying it, because as you get older in your career, that's how you start to think. There's no reason why you should think that with every single appearance that you have with your football club.
Yeah, and that'll be interesting to see where the selection and then the mindset go out there and win it. No, I think no matter what team they put out there, they'll expect to win, and they should win the game. That doesn't mean they will. In the past, they've sometimes struggled with that kind of expectation against some of them lower teams, and they get up for these games because the TFC coming in are, you know, the Eastern Conference champs, so these teams will step up a little bit. And you know, I think there's an expectation there that TFC will just go out there and win it no matter what they do. And to be frank, it should be an inner expectation from whoever gets that shirt. You know, I think Greg Vanney has been reluctant a little bit to change too much because he doesn't want to lose that momentum. But if he does change it, it's up to those players on Sunday to say, this is my chance. And the rest of those players who aren't playing right now have reached the level. Now I've got to reach that level and beyond to say that I want to play more minutes. That's ultimately how you evolve a top class team over and over again, is that you set the standard and they have to come in and meet that standard consistently to say, I've now got the trust of the coaching staff here.
Our thanks to John Herdman and to Tony Gallagher for joining the show today. Thanks to you for watching and listening wherever you are. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. And we'll see you Sunday, TFC against Cincinnati.
Have a good week.